I like filming stuff. So this opportunity came about. My friend Danny here is a childhood friend of mine. It's come around that through Facebook we've found each other again. I remember when I worked with Danny, it was very precision based, you know what I mean? And it wasn't so much all about the dynamics, it was actually about the variety of movements and, created moves that we tried to master. So then, I'm like, my knees ain't too bad. So, let's document it again. And that's where we are. And the deep thing for me is that we named the group the Untouchable Force. And I think that statement originally came out, it was ego based. You know, we're the Untouchable Force because we was young. But now with adult eyes looking back, you know, and both of us being in our 50s now, that force is not touched by time, age, circumstance. We were homeless when we were doing this dance thing, but all of the problems that we had seemed to go away when we danced. It just seemed to be that force of creativity wasn't touched by our situations back then. And they're not touched by our situations right now.
Ole!
Sort of makes sense, you know, the name Untouchable Force now, it makes more sense.
Yeah.
Back then it was just a name, but now it makes sense because, you know...
Well, I think we were trying to make it represent us.
Yeah.
Back then, but I think what it does, it represents creativity.
Creativity.
And we asked that... We called up that force again and it's here. There are strict rules that we had to do this. It was our life. Every day, it was an everyday occurrence. And it wasn't one of the things in the list of things to do and priorities in our life. It was the priority.
The priority.
Yeah. And I think that's the unique thing about artists that are able to do their thing. But we can prioritise. We can make it the be all and end all of our life. Feeling to move was structured into a piece of choreography to represent their energy. Then we wanted to dress it, we wanted to look good. Here we are again, paying homage to the painkiller.
<laughs> dancing back then, you know, it was an enjoyable thing and I enjoyed it. We all enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Years down the line and I'm still enjoying it. And I think that's an important part of it. Dancing is an enjoyable thing. It's not like, you know, you've got to do it because you've got to be better than so on and so forth. You've just got to enjoy it.
I can't talk about nightclubs being my favourite place. I think that was a thing for people that went and came to watch dancers. That was, so the club meant something to them. The club didn't mean anything to me. Do you know what I mean? Because I was dancing in the street anyway. We were dancing outside the window of Barking train station, you know, and there's a takeaway place there. And when it closed and it was dark at night, the window turned into a mirror, and that's where we used to rehearse.
That's right.
And, you know, people now, they're like, oh, I remember this DJ and that DJ. And I'm not being funny, but we knew what music to play for us to keep dancing. And when we were together, every tune that we played made us dance. When I went out to clubs and these DJs tried to emulate our culture, I was standing around a lot of the time on the floor waiting for them to play something decent for me to dance to, because a lot of these DJs can't dance.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So this is not about an era or a nightclub or a DJ or a scene. This is about a piece of choreography that I remember going to clubs and stuff like that, and guys trying to battle me with the move I invented. But that guy got it from 15 other dudes.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That claimed it, that it was theirs.
Hand me down, yeah.
Right, you know what I mean? And I'm going against the guy. The guy's doing my move. He doesn't even know I'm the inventor of the move, and then looks surprised when I destroy him. And I've seen also your moves flying all over the place, and nobody knows where they come from, you know what I mean? And you ask these people, say, what's the name of that move you're doing? And they either lie and give you some rubbish answer about it, or they don't know. But we had names tipping in the kitchen, Patty Duke. We had names for all the moves, you know what I mean? The Muslim, you know what I mean? And we knew the people that invented them.
Yeah.
Yeah, so here we are, trying to get the bodies to do what they were doing when we was that, 14? 13, 14 years old?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Wow. Eating Weetabix with water and sugar. You can't just get off your couch and come and do this.
No.
The body was like, you know what I mean? You better develop. And, you know, I have developed. I feel my tendons have got longer. You know what I mean? And my balance has become better during the process, because that's what it asks of you. So it's like a magical thing, that, like you said, the untouchable force, because it makes your body evolve. If you apply the discipline properly, your body will evolve. You know what I mean? Definitely, I feel a lot healthier, you know what I mean? Stamina's better. You know what I mean? So it kind of physiologically, I've found out a new appreciation for the dance at this age. Because at that age, it was just, you know, some surface stuff like attention and girls and all of these type of things and popularity. And now as I'm older, it's a therapy, physiologically and psychologically.
Agreed.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Untouchable force. Years later.
Still
working,
untouched.
And still working.
Yeah, man.